Hello everyone, welcome to the Turning Point. In this session, let's see some of geometry commands which are useful in creating a geometry. With the help of these commands, you can create a geometry, or with the combination of these commands, you can create a complex geometry, which is a combination of different geometries. Let us see these commands. So here there are different ways of activating a command. You may activate through this toolbar, or you may activate through this menu bar. So you can go to draw and then you can activate a command, or otherwise with the help of command window, just by entering the shortcut for that, you can activate a command. Suppose if I want to activate line, so just I can click on this one, or otherwise with the help of command window, just type L and then press enter or space, right? So when you activate a command, so what is the next thing you have to do? So that will be mentioned in the command window. So if you observe there, specify first point. So that is the first point, and I want to create a horizontal line. So you have to activate ortho mode. For activating ortho mode, press F8. So I want to have a line which is of length 10 units. So type the 10 and then press enter. So line is created. Again, press enter or escape to cancel the command. So a line, a horizontal line of length 10 is created. So now if I want to create a line which is vertical from this point, so I want to draw a vertical line of 5. So again, activate the command and specify this one as the first point and mention the length. So I have created a line of 5 units. So this is line. So the next tool is construction line. So there is a difference between line and construction line. So here you can observe this figure. If you want to create a geometry, so these will be useful as a guidelines. So these will be in the background. So based upon them, you can create an object. So here that may be horizontal or vertical or inclined. You can create any type of construction line. So you can activate this one by clicking on this tool. Command will be activated. After that, if you observe here, horizontal, vertical, angular, different things are there. So first let us see horizontal. So to activate that, HOR enter. So if you observe there, so now my cursor is changed like this, and whatever may be the location you specify there, and if you give left click, so there will be a horizontal construction line created. To cancel this one, just press escape or space or enter. So if you move throughout the drawing area here, so here this line will be until the end of the drawing area. So that is the difference between a line and construction line. Just line means it is a specific thing. So it is a combination of two points, and that will be up to a specific area in the drawing sheet only. But the construction line will be spread over the entire drawing sheet, right? So here I have created a horizontal construction line. Next, if I want to create a vertical construction line, I will use one command. Again, the same command. Excel is the shortcut if you want to activate through command window. So type Excel and then press enter or space. So now I want to create vertical one. So VER enter. So vertical one. So I have created a vertical one, right? So if I want to create angular one, so which is at an inclination of 45 degrees. So ANG angular. And when you mention the angular one, you have to mention the angle of inclination. Here it is asking to specify the angle of inclination. I have given it as 45 degrees. Now if you observe, so a line is attached to the cursor, and that line is at an inclination of 45 degrees. So just specify the point where you want to locate it and give a left click. So it will be over. So cancel the command. This is construction line. Construction line will be spread over the entire drawing sheet. So here the next command is polyline. So there is a difference between line and polyline, so I will tell you later. First, how to activate this one. So just left click on this one, or shortcut is PL enter in the command window. First you have to specify point, next point, and then next point. So now here line is useful only for drawing lines that may be horizontal or vertical or angle at an angle, so you can draw lines like that. So here polyline not only drawing for horizontal, vertical, angular lines, you can draw arcs also. Okay, so if I want to draw arc from this point, so just arc. So now you can draw arc. Okay, the radius you can mention with the mouse, or otherwise you can do one thing. So here if you want to draw at a radius of 5, so RAD enter. So it is asking me to specify the radius. Just I have entered 5 units, so with the help of command window I have given the radius as 5. So with the radius 5, they have created an arc. So now you can specify directly with the help of mouse, so you can observe what is the dimension there, or directly give the dimension there, right? So I have given there. So now I don't want to draw any arcs furthermore. For that reason I want to go to again line mode. So for that, what you have to do is L enter. So again it is converted to line, right? Lines. So cancel the command, press escape or space or enter, right? So here earlier I have drawn these with the help of a line command, and this one with polyline command. So the difference now I'm going to show. So when you select this one, when you click on that one, only this line segment is selected, right? So here this polyline is a combination of different segments, lines, arcs, different things are there. So when I click on a line segment, not only the selected line segment, the entire combination of lines, arcs, everything is selected there. Entire thing is selected there. So that is the difference. Here line is nothing but combination of line segments. Here it is also combination, but when you select, everything will be selected. So that is the difference between a line and polyline. When you want to convert a 2D model into a 3D model, so there you have to make the line into a polyline. So we will see in the further sessions later, right? So this is the difference between, just you know the difference for this session, this is the difference between line and polyline. You can convert line into a polyline and polyline into a line. So that one we will see in editing commands, right? Okay, now next one, polygon. So here you can activate through this one, or otherwise shortcut is POL enter, polygon. So when you select polygon, first you have to mention what is the number of sides. So mention the number of sides. I have given 6, and specify the center of polygon. So this one I have specified center. Enter an option, inscribed or circumscribed. So inscribed is the default option. Okay, here no inscribing, no circumscribing, whatever may be the option you give, no problem. So enter, and specify the radius. So one thing you can do, you can directly mention with the help of a keyboard directly, or otherwise you can enter the radius here with the help of mouse you can do, or with the help of keyboard. So directly I have given with the mouse, right? Again, polygon, POL shortcut. Enter number of sides, 5 I have given. So specify the center of polygon, inscribed or circumscribed. Okay, specify the radius, like that, right? So here this is a line segment. Here it is a combination of lines, but when you select a polygon, every line segment will be selected, right? So for selecting all these simultaneously, you can use Ctrl A and then press delete to erase, or otherwise when you drag from down, the green color screen will be there, green color rectangular blocks will be there. So if you select like it like that, everything will be selected. When you drag from the top, only blue color will be there. So, but whatever may be the object which is completely present, then that one only will be selected there, right? So that is the difference. Okay, so now I would like to select all and then delete, Control A and then press delete on keyboard, right? So this is about polygon. So minimum three number of polygons we can minimum number of sides is three and maximum number of sides are 1024, right? And now rectangle. So to activate this command, REC, type REC in command window. So here to draw rectangle, you have to do two things only: specify the first left corner, okay, and specify the other corner. Or otherwise, you can do in the reverse way also: specify one corner, specify other corner. Okay, you have to specify two corners in order to draw the rectangle, right? So if you want to draw rectangle by dimensions, how to do it? Specify the first corner, and if you know the dimensions, then dim enter. Okay, here it is asking to enter the length of the rectangle, so I'm giving it as 15. Enter the width of the rectangle, I'm giving it as 10. So rectangle came, but it is not located. You have to specify the other corner point. So you can specify with the help of mouse like this, or otherwise you can specify, if you know the coordinates directly, you can specify on the command window, right? So just I'm giving a click, so command is over, rectangle is created as per the given dimensions, right? If you know the dimensions, you can do like this, or if you know the area and one dimension, then you can do select this command, specify first corner point, and then go to area command, area, specify the area units. So I'm giving it as 100 and the length I'm giving it as 20. Okay, calculate the rectangle dimensions based on length or width. So defaultly length is there, so I'm taking the default option. Specify enter the rectangle length 15. So rectangle is created, right? So in these cases, when you draw objects, if some object is there, so if some object is gone away from the screen, then use this command Z Enter, E Enter, so then it will be fit to screen. Zoom extend. So we will discuss these commands in further sessions. So this is about rectangle. Next, arc. So when you activate through command window or toolbar, only one option is there. So arc is activated, first point, second point, third point. Okay, to activate through command window, so type A. So command will through command window, you can activate it. Specify first point, specify second point, specify third point. So this is the only type of arc we can activate through these two methods. So if you go through menu bar, go to draw and then arc. So here you are having different options: start, center, end, start, center, angle, start, end, radius. Likewise, there are different options. Okay, here you have to observe the terminology in the order: start, end, radius. First I have to give start and then end and then radius. So I will select this option, start, this is end. Now I have to give the radius, so you can enter the radius value. Suppose if I give 4, so with the radius 4, a arc is created by specifying start and end points. So if you want to draw arc by another option, center, start, angle, this is center, this is the start. Okay, now you have to mention the angle. So likewise, different options are there, so you can activate different commands in different ways. Okay, right? But when you go through menu for arc, so you have lot of options there. Next command is circle. To activate circle, click on this toolbar, or otherwise shortcut through command window is C enter. So after giving that command, so when the command is activated, so it will ask you to specify the center point and then radius. Radius you can mention with the help of mouse, or through keyboard just you can enter the value. So 10 I am giving there as radius. So circle is created, right? Again, C enter, command is activated, specify the center point and then radius, right? C enter, center point. So here, if you want to give diameter instead of radius, so D enter there. So then it will ask you to enter the diameter observe there in the command window. So give the diameter, diameter is 5. So likewise, a circle is created as per given radius or diameter. Let's see some other options associated with circle command. Activate the command. So for activating, C enter. So here in bracket you can see TP, 2P, TTR. So let us see these options. First, I will select 3P. So 3P means 3 points. So if you mention 3 points, so with the help of those 3 points, you can create a circle. First point, second point, third point, right? So how to specify 3 points? Again, circle. So to activate this one, so 3P enter, first point, second point. So whatever may be the location you specify the third point, so there circle will be created by specifying 3 points. Let us see circle with 2 points. Circle 2P. Specify the first point and specify the next point. So then the circle will be created by specifying 2 points. Nothing but if you know the diameter of the circle, then you can use this one, right? Next, circle with the TTR, that is tangent tangent radius. So first I will draw circle. So I have drawn one circle, another circle, right? And the circle I have drawn two circles. So now I want to draw a circle which is tangential to these two circles at a given specified radius. So now I will use this command circle. So for activating this one, type TTR, tangent tangent radius. Specify point on object for the tangent of first circle. So I have specified this one as first point. That means the circle what I want to draw, that should touch this point, and this is the next point. Now I have to specify the radius from this point to this point, consider as radius. Now a circle is drawn. A circle is drawn by touching those two points and at a given specified radius. So this is a revision plot, right? So REV plot. So instead of using that command, so better to click on this icon. So here this will be useful for giving a detail. Suppose if I want to give this detail, just I will do like this, right? So to activate this one, click on just this one and give left click and move the mouse in the desired way, and if you reach the starting point, then the command will be cancelled, right? So this is revision plot. So if you want to give any detailed detail in the given drawing, in the drawing you want to mention, so here you can use this command. This is revision plot, right? Next command is spline. Okay, so it creates a smooth curve that passes through the specified points. Okay, so just left click on that one, specify first point, specify next point, specify next point, specify next point. So likewise you can draw until you cancel the command, right? So I have canceled. So after drawing also you can edit whether it is line or spline. You can edit again, click on that blue color button, so it will be converted to red. So then you can increase the pitch or decrease the pitch, even it is in the case of a line also. Okay, so I have drawn line. So when I select that, so three blue color dots are there, right? So if you again click on that blue color dot, so then you can stretch that line, right? So you can stretch a line or spline by clicking at the end portion, right? So these are the commands which will be useful in drawing or creating a geometry. Hope these commands are useful for you. If you like this video, click on like button and do subscribe my channel for further updates. Thank you all.